Good evening, one and all. I welcome you all to Wiki Wisdom Session 2. Here, Arundhati ma'am will be talking about yoga mudras and all. So I would hand it over to Christian to take it further. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Indeed, it's my privilege and honor to introduce one stalwart, an incredible educator. She is none other than Dr. Arundhati Huskari, an educationist who is multi-talented and passionate teacher. She's a lifelong learner, a linguist, motivational speaker, trainer, poet, journalist, author of books, and the list goes endless. She's been heading the International Cambridge IB School for 21 years as a principal and director. She's been a consultant to ICSE schools, and she is a recipient of many awards internationally and internationally. She's a qualified intellectual who's a master's in English, MSc, MEd, English literature, PhD in education. She's done her diploma from Trinity College for Public Speaking, London. A great leader, a visionary who's known for her leadership, her erudition, teaching skills, a naturopathy doctor, and who has dealt with many, she has many followers. This is just a small readable script, but she is definitely an immense, knowledgeable person who is really very passionate to learn and to share. So it's my privilege and honor to introduce such a wonderful speaker, eminent speaker amidst us.
Thank you, Christina, for that wonderful introduction. But about me, I'm just a teacher and a lifelong learner. And currently I'm a consultant to Cambridge International Schools. And I have many interests, and this is one of them. Naturopathy is one of them. So today I will be taking you through mudras. So first of all, let us take a quick background about mudras I would like to give. See, if you look at it, man is called a crown of creation. Man is called a divine creation. And the most complex machine ever created in this world. Okay. So human brain, if you think, it is the best computer ever made. We can't clone another human brain. We can make so many programmings on the computer, but it's very difficult to manufacture a human brain. And human mind is very, very powerful. If you develop the mind power, you can heal yourself, and also you can heal other, feel fit and heal others also. And you can be healthy, and you can make your family and friends healthy. So that is the thing. Now, our ancient sages have given the secret of yoga and meditation. And mudras are a part of yogic practice, and which is nothing but hand gestures, okay? So using specific fingers to activate the nerve centers and get rid of the diseases. A small thing, like I'm not deviating from the topic, but I'm telling you something. If you see Lord Krishna, when he is, teaching Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Gita is actually Arjuna is depressed, and he is doing a therapy for him. You know, it's a psychotherapy what he is giving. So the mudra is kept like this. So all the time, Lord Krishna is one of the first psychiatrists in the entire world, I would say. So that is what powerful. And when you see any people meditating, they always hold the fingers in a particular fashion. Somebody holds it like this. If it's Bhagwan Buddha, he holds it like this. If it is Shiva, he holds it like this. So everything is related. So we are going to explore this science and how it is exactly going to help us, you know. And actually, we often rub our hands. You just observe your own behavior. We press our hands in anxiety, and then we keep on washing them. Now, though, don't talk about washing, because we have become expert in hand washing. Somebody ate something in China, and whole world is washing their hands. That is our situation today, just in a lighter way. And the list is endless with what kinds of things we do. And even if we are very, even when you want to curse others, or when you cleanse the face, or when you're happy, we say, wow. And there are so many gestures wherein we use our fingers very freely. Now, human is the only species who has got the opposable thumb. That is why we are able to bring all the fingers together and we are able to perform so many artistic skills. So blessed we are. So using our own fingers, we can also heal. Actually, we have the potential to heal ourselves using this mudra. Mudra signifies a kind of a mystical position of our hands and a gesture done in a particular way. A single gesture like bending, then, you know, crossing or like this, or touching the fingers with other fingertips or touching the mounts on the hand, we can heal ourselves. I'll be taking you through every aspect of it. But only one thing. See, today it's an instant zamana. Like, you know, everything we want instant. Instant gratification. You put up, you order pizza within 30 minutes, it's delivered. Put a pizza in the microwave, it's done in 5 minutes. So all these kind of, you know, like we want instant gratification. But ancient sciences, whether it is naturopathy, like, you know, herbal medicine or Ayurvedic medicine or yoga or mudras or whatever we talk of, or healing through chakras. So that's another beautiful science. All these things are actually slow in giving the result, but the results are permanent. It is not like popping up a crossin or a Calpol 500 and then immediately feeling relief in 20 minutes, the pain is gone. It's not going to be like that. It takes time, but it definitely works. So what you have to understand is, to have that effect, we have to continuously practice it for the specified number of periods. Whatever the problem ailment comes, we tell them practice it for 1 month or 2 months, or, you know, till you get healed. So that is one thing you have to remember. So continuous practice of these mudras will create a kind of minute changes, okay, in our body using the pulse centers. I'll be talking to you what are pulse centers of the hands, which trigger certain healing processes within the corresponding body parts. Now, mudras are actually performed with both the hands. You should not keep only one hand in a particular mudra, what I'm going to say. It is always done with both the hands, because, see, our hands, our body, the entire body, we have a bilateral symmetry, right? Exactly opposite side may all the body parts are arranged. That's a bilateral symmetry. So what happens is our right hemisphere and left hemisphere are connected completely. So if you want the healing to occur, then you have to use both the hands. That you have to remember. And you can begin practicing the mudras with 10 minutes in a day. You can go up to 45 minutes. Now the next question you may ask, all right, you are telling us to do with the 10 minutes and all that. Where is the time? We don't have time. Everybody has got only 24 hours in a day. Nobody gets extra time. If you want to learn something, if you want to make something, then you have to find out that time, and then only it is possible. All right. With that background, now one more thing, like, when to practice mudras becomes another headache. When do I practice? I don't have time. Don't worry. You watch TV at least 15, 20 minutes in a day or half an hour in a day. That time you can do your mudras. You travel to work. If you are not driving, if you're, you know, you drive, somebody else is driving for you, that time you can practice. Even when you're conducting your parent meets or somebody you're talking, nobody is going to see what you're keeping your hands underneath. You can sit in a particular mudra and heal yourself. See, where there is a will, there is a way. If you want to do something, you can do it. So that should be your commitment. Only thing what is required is commitment. Now, all our five fingers represent five elements. As we all know, our entire body is made up of five elements. So all of you, I'm sure you know about this. That is Agni, or the fire element, then Vayu, that is the air element, ether or space, and then this is earth element, Prithvi Tattva, and then this last one is a water element or Jala Tattva. So all these five Pancha Bhutas, what we call in yogic language, these make up our body. So whenever there is imbalance of any of these things, now you may ask, where is Agni in my body? Of course, it is there. All our entire process of digestion is taking place through that, and our body is kept warm, heat is released. So that is Agni Tattva. And then, you know, if you talk of Jala Tattva or water, water is continuously flowing in our body in terms of your body fluids and your tears and your, like, you know, other body fluids plus your blood. So continuous, or entire lymphatic system if you take. So all the elements are there. when there is a balance, particular balance in a particular thing, then all the problems begin. So mudra tells us you can actually bring those things under control by using a specific gesture. Now what I am going to show is very, very important. Before I proceed with the slideshow and talk about types of mudras, please pay attention. Whenever we want to do the gestures, don't hold the fingers like this tight, then you won't feel anything. I want every one of you to touch it very gently, as if you're touching a newborn baby, just very gently. And you know, just keep to yourself. I'm not going to talk for 30 seconds and you observe, you can feel actually the pulsation in your fingers. Please try that. Show me thumbs up if you could feel the pulsation. You could feel it? Very gently and calm down totally. Don't press them. Just touch peripherally. Could you experience, anybody? Show me thumbs up if you experienced. You got it, Anita?
No, ma'am.
Very gently, and focus on that, those two points only. Don't think anything.
Am I actually the right position?
Position is right. See, all you have to do is just how you touch a very newborn baby, so gently you touch, don't press at all.
Okay.
You actually start feeling kind of throbbing sensation.
Yes. Now I did.
If you immediately don't worry, you will definitely feel it because it's so powerful and it's so good, like, you know. And now I'll be present. Why I told this is very important for us. Rachna, I can't put a full screen, right? Rachna?
Ma'am, it's visible. It's totally visible.
No. Do I make it a full screen? Is it okay?
I think this is proper. If you want, you can do a full screen also, the way, whichever ways you want. It's showing full screen only side me.
Okay, theek hai. See, I was explaining this to you, the five elements represented by our fingers. This we have already seen, so I'm not going to take time on this slide. So actually, if you see, if any of you have learned Bharatanatyam, you will be knowing the gestures, all the mudras also there. Also, you are not supposed to. There is no time for you because the gestures have to be done, pataka, all the things have to be done very quickly and very swiftly and very gently. So there also the mudras are used. Actually, Bharat Muni wrote this Bharatanatyam Shastra based on the yogic practices. All the gestures and the footwork and everything. This is, I'm not going to take it away from the topic, but I just, out of interest, I showed it to you. Now I'll be quickly moving towards the mudras itself, so that something you will learn today, you know, what's the takeaway. Now, the first thing is Jnana Mudra. Jnana Mudra is called as Mudra of Knowledge. This is when I mentioned Lord Krishna. I can't help but tell you a small incident. In the US, we went to one psychiatrist's clinic because he's a good friend of ours. He's an American only. And in his office, where he was seated behind was a huge, photograph of Lord Krishna standing and Arjuna, he is giving that discourse of Gita. So I asked him, wow, you are having this photograph. You know what he said? I have to have it, Arunati, because he is the first psychiatrist of the world. So that powerful, so this Jnana Mudra reminded me of that. This is a mudra of knowledge. Now, this mudra, particular mudra, enhances the knowledge. The tip of the thumb has centers of pituitary gland and endocrine glands. So when we press these centers by index finger and the two glands work very actively. Pressing is not hard. It's very gentle, very gentle. You'll have to keep it. So this gesture you can keep any time of the day, any amount of time. There is no time restriction, nothing. And you know what? Even while going to sleep, you can put this. And this is known to cure insomnia, that is sleeplessness. And also it increases, why it is called Jnana Mudra? Because it increases the memory power and then it sharpens the mind, sharpens the brain. And then regular practice will, you know, cure even the conditions like hysteria and agitation and anger and depression and so on. So this is Jnana Mudra. What I made you right now practice is Jnana Mudra. Now the next one is Varuna Mudra. Varuna Mudra is again, I told you this is thumb is fire and this is water element. So whenever there is any imbalance in water element and the certain problems occur, like gastroenteritis is there, a muscle shrinkage, suddenly you get cramps in the body, especially the legs and the feet. So at that time, this mudra comes very handy. Please try this again. Touch these two fingers very gently and check out for a sensation whether you're going to feel the throbbing. So it prevents all diseases due to lack of disease or even excess of disease. So that is where we call it balance. Then the time again, there is no specific duration. You can do it any amount of time, you know. So it retains clarity in the blood because it thins the blood and it regulates the blood flow. And helps in pains like gastroenteritis, dysentery, and any stomach ailments, and then the muscle shrinkage and muscle cramps and everything. And even sometimes tension headache, it even helps sinusitis because sinusitis is also caused due to the blockage of sinus on the face area. Okay. Could you feel the throbbing in these two fingers? Anybody? I'm not able to hear. Could you feel the throbbing?
I couldn't. Are
you, mentally busy with something or are you worked up or something like that?
No, nothing like that.
So just touch very gently, dear. Very gently.
Actually, I'm unable to fold them. You know, like when you have to fold these two fingers, you know, your little finger and your thumb. So the rest of them are also, you know, getting folded. So that is a problem.
Like this you do?
Yes. Now it's okay.
You're able to feel the throbbing, right?
Yes, now I can. Earlier, I couldn't.
But you know what? You must do this then. There is some like water element ka problem. Like if you are not even able to fold the fingers and all that. So you must try this mudra. It will definitely help you, you know.
Sure.
So why this is coming as a strip? Okay. Now let's quickly go to the next one. See, this is called as Shunya Mudra. Okay. What is that? See, Shunya Mudra, Shunya means what? Emptiness. Okay. So this is mudra for emptiness. What do I mean by this? First of all, let us understand how to do the middle finger. Middle finger denotes space. Okay. So you'll have to fold the middle finger with your thumb. Try to keep the remaining straight. See, out of that, ring finger is the weakest finger in the hand. So it may not stand stiff. Don't worry about that. As long as you have folded this middle finger, but there is a technique of folding this middle finger. It's not anywhere. See, on the right, on your hand, the mount below the thumb is called as Venus mount. Okay. This is called as Venus mount. There is an arch, you see, now this thing. So this is called Venus mount. So you have to hold this Venus mount again, very gently. Don't press hard. Then just gently close this and keep. See, even my ring finger, actually picture in the hand also is, picture of hand in the PPT also is my hand only. I photographed and put it. So naturally, this is bending because it's the weakest finger. Okay, so you have to hold it like this. Now, what is the specialty? This actually reduces the dullness in our body. Actually, the whole face becomes bright if you practice this every day, 40 to 60 minutes a day until whatever time you want, you know. Now, another thing, in the middle of the night, suppose you start getting earache, this mudra is like a Ramban, I can say. You can start this mudra and immediately will feel relief in the ear pain within 5 to 7 minutes only, 4 to 5 minutes sometimes or little more at times. But this is a very, very powerful. So this mudra, you have to teach to children also. And I mean, you have to learn because anything to do with the ear, sometimes, you know, there is a more wax formation or suddenly the ear pain begins in the midnight where you're going to run, you can just do this. Because nowadays, earlier when we were growing up small and all that time, our mothers used coconut oil or whatever oil and they used to heat it and put. Now it is forbidden. We are not supposed to put any oil in this thing that can cause infection which can reach brain. So we are not supposed to put any oil in the ear. So this is a very good thing. Okay. And earache, I mentioned about this. And it's also useful for the people who are deaf and mentally challenged, but not a born deaf, like, you know, suddenly sometimes there is a problem in the ear and they can't hear. So that kind of a temporary deafness can be cured. If a person is born deaf, then this condition, this mudras are not going to help him.
Ma'am, we have not done the previous mudra. I think we missed out the Varunwala mudra.
Why? Varunwala you missed out?
Okay. Yes.
The first one we did. Okay. After that we didn't. Varun we did. The next one.
Okay. So Vayu Mudra is again a mudra of air, you know. It prevents the diseases that occur due to imbalance of air. Vayu is what? Vayu is air, all right? So only thing is five fingers. You'll have to remember the elements represented by the five fingers. That is it, like, you know. So this is Agni, this is Vayu. Middle one is the space or Akasha. Then this is the earth. And this is the water. Earth and water are together. Air and, fire are together. The middle one is the space or Akasha. That's very easy to remember. So here, what you have to do is, whenever there is any disease that is occurring due to imbalance of air, people generally what comes to our mind is maybe gas in the stomach or, you know, indigestion. No. There are a lot of things like rheumatism, arthritis, gout, Parkinson's disease, paralysis, then, you know, cervical spondylitis, paralysis of face, and then tension headache, and nerve catch, and, you know, and the trapezius swelling. Sometimes it's a professional hazard for the teachers. Continuously you sit and type or go on doing the corrections or any kind of writing work and all that, this portion gets stiff. Okay, people think it's a frozen shoulder. No, it's not a frozen shoulder always. Frozen shoulder is a different condition. For us, the professional hazard is this particular muscle is called as trapezius muscle at the back. So that goes into spasm. That also is air imbalance, okay? Or, you know, getting tension headaches. And then, of course, gas element in the stomach also when there is indigestion or a bacterial infection that happens. So basically, you will have to do it, you know, for 45 minutes. And severity of the disease will be reduced within 12 to 24 hours. So 45 minutes means another thing I'll tell you. You may ask like, where we are going to get 45 minutes continuously? Don't do 45 minutes continuously if you can't. You can break it into 20 minutes or you could break it into 15 into 3, whatever. If you do more, it's not going to harm you. If you do less, the effect will be less. No harm again. So how do you do this? Again, you have to fold this thumb or fold this finger, the first finger, and then touch it like this. See, very simple. And whatever you do, you'll have to do with both the hands. That's the bottom line. So this is Vayu Mudra. Now Vayu Mudra also, if you put too much pressure with the thumb, then you won't hear any sensation. You have to be gentle, then fold it gently, concentrate and try to hear that pulse or, you know, throbbing, that throbbing sensation. If you can't immediately do it, see, this is something new. Your mind has to accept and you have to think in those terms and then you will get, don't worry about it. By practice, you will definitely start feeling the pulses the minute you get into mudra. So Shunya Mudra we did, I think, earache. Now it is Surya Mudra, Mudra for the sun. Okay. Now, bend the ring finger and press it with the thumb. Again, don't press, overpress it. Then, you know, it will, your finger will start aching and you're not going to do more than 30 seconds also. Very gently again. See, this portion is touching this portion. Everywhere nerves are there on, in our body. That is the science behind it. You know, it sharpens the sense, center of thyroid gland. Actually, the time duration is daily. You can practice it for 5 to 15 minutes. It's excellent. And nowadays, you know, like so many youngsters, young women complain of thyroid. Everybody and anybody. Thyroid and PCOD, these two are the things very often women are complaining. And some girls, so they make so much of effort to lose the weight. But if they have this thyroidism, they will not lose the weight at all. Come what may. You go starving, you do exercise, nothing happens. So the imbalance in the body has to be corrected. That, you know, thyroid secretion has to be corrected. So this is one, of course, you have to take medicine. I'm not saying that only you do this and you'll get cure of thyroid. No, whatever your medical medicines are there, you'll have to take. And I have got lot of home remedies also for all these diseases. My book is available in Amazon. I've written everything from the kitchen. It's not Ayurvedic book. Everything, what wisdom I have gained from my family, my mother, my grandmother, my grandfather, my father. So it was, they were all time and tested remedies. So if you want, you could go through that. So if you hold this like this, this will definitely help. And this also helps in decreasing the cholesterol in your body. And it reduces anxiety. And also it corrects your digestion. Okay, so this mudra also is very, very powerful. Yeah. Somebody wants to ask something? Anuradha, who is it?
Yeah, ma'am, yeah. I would love to know the book, name of your book, which you have written on Amazon. It's available to kindly share the name of the book.
Yeah, it is available. Also. Even Kindle version is there. And physical book is there. The name is like Home Remedies for Common Ailments by Dr. Arundhati Hoskeri.
Perfect, ma'am. Perfect. Thank you.
I think at the end, I will put it in the chat box if anybody wants to buy it.
Yeah, that will be great, ma'am.
Yeah. So this is Surya Mudra and it corrects indigestion. And another thing I'll tell you, most of the thing, actually in that Home Remedies book, I have classified the diseases according to, in my own way, different way. Like, you know, it's all women specific ailments I have put together and it's very handy. And at the end, I speak 10 languages, so I have written all the equivalent terminology in at least 8 or 9 languages. Now I offhand suddenly I can't remember. The book was published in 2012 first and then 14. It was released in Sri Lanka and it's catching up very well. Like, you know, it's widely read, especially out of India. A lot of people are buying because they don't get over-the-counter medicines there. Now here, even the pharmacist pay like a doctor and he can say, okay, buy this, buy that. I see. You go to a medical shop, people come and ask as though they are doctors, give me all these people who are unaware. So, but outside they don't get that. So this book comes very handy and all are harmless. Everything is from the kitchen. That much I can say. All right. Now, after this, this is Prana Mudra. Now look at the Prana Mudra. Bend the ring finger, little finger and touch the tip of the thumb. It means first two fingers are free. This is a very easy mudra anybody can do. Try to keep the two fingers straight. These two fingers straight. Okay. And actually, this mudra is called prana means life. Mudra for life. It improves the power of life. And actually, people who are weak, mentally weak, physically weak, they can do. Mentally weak means I'm not talking of people having the problem. Some people are very emotional. They just can't take anything for no. Or they just can't tolerate anybody's comments. So oversensitive people, they are also weak-minded. So, and also physically, if you're feeling all the time tired and, you know, debilitated, you can use this mudra. And it reduces the clamps in the blood vessels. And if you practice it regularly, we will become very active. Again, there is no specific time period for this. You can do it as, even when you take a walk, why don't you do, you know, instead of holding a mobile and again exposing yourself to radiation, walking while talking, you can start doing mudras to improve your health. Like, you know, it improves your immunity also, improves the power of eyes and reduces eye-related diseases, and it removes fatigue also. If you do this mudra, actually, these are all the mudras. I'm just introduction I'm giving you. For a particular thing, there are mudras plus combinations and plus everything. When it is given together, they work wonders. So many people have experienced and given me positive feedback about it. So this is a very simple mudra, prana mudra. Anything what you find convenient, you can start doing while walking, even while cooking. If you are using one hand, other hand can be engaged in mudras, while watching television, while in the gym also. Anytime, anything, whatever like you get time, you can do. And this is apana mudra. Apana mudra is the deer ka pose, mruga, like this. So this is actually fold the middle two fingers and then touch the thumb. Again, very gentle, very gentle. While other two fingers are straight, it plays an important role in our health as it regulates the excretory system. So 45 minutes per day for the best result, you'll have to practice it longer. And it helps in the bowel movements and cures constipation and controls and regulates diabetes. Nowadays, all youngsters, even in mid-30s, people have started developing diabetes because these are all lifestyle diseases, diabetes, blood pressure, thyroid. You may be having the best of everything, but if you have stress, these are all stress-related things. And another thing, if you have elders at home, and especially over 75 or 80, 85, urine continency is lost, they have to visit the loo. I've seen so many elders hesitant to even go out for 1 hour. They say, no, I have to use the bathroom at least 3-4 times. So I stopped going. That's not a good idea at all, because you have to move around, you have to go. So if you make them practice, it's very simple. If you make them practice, but only thing, as I told in the beginning also, there is no magic wand that one day I will sit in a mudra and next day it is gone. No, you have to practice it. You will have to do it for a longer period of time, and then only you will be able to achieve the result. Then this is a very, very important thing. Before I read out and explain, I'd like to tell you very clearly. Actually, Apana Vayu Mudra is also called as Mudra of Heart. Suppose a person is in the house, if you in the middle of the night or even at home, like a person gets a heart attack or something, if you just take his or her fingers and do this mudra, immediately it acts like your tablet sorbitrate. Sorbitrate is a tablet which immediately, sublingual tablet, it is keep under the tongue and it brings down the blood pressure and all that. It is that powerful. It's not going to reverse the heart attack, but you can definitely gain some time before actual medical help arrives. And that itself is a blessing. Many a times, people, before they reach the hospital or before the medical aid comes, they are in a big trouble. So you could please remember this mudra, and especially if you have elders in the family, please teach them this. And it doesn't take much time and it doesn't cost anything. So how do we do this Apana Mudra? See, the tip of the middle finger and ring finger touch the tip of the thumb, and the index finger touches the base of the thumb. Now, what do I mean by this? This is my index finger. Base of the thumb means Venus mount again. See, this is the Venus mount. So where is the base? Here is the base. So I'm touching it very gently. This is the only thing what you have to remember. Now, other three fingers you have to bring. If you can't bring all the four, it will be a closed heart. It's an open heart. See. I will show it again. This is my thumb. These are my index fingers. Index finger, gently I'm touching at the base of my thumb. And then what I'm doing? Thumb and these two fingers I'm bringing together, and little finger, pinky is up. I'm just keeping these two fingers like this. This is called as, actually if you observe it, it looks like heart. Observe your own hand like this. It looks like heart. So this is called as mudra of heart. So it works like an injection and reduces the heart attack, and it acts like a powerful sorbitrate tablet, reduces the gas content in the body. And then again, heart patients and BP patients can practice it for 15 minutes daily for better results, or 30 minutes also. It's a very good mudra actually. If you suffer from even little hypertension, leave the heart attack. Even if you have hypertension, or even hypotension, lower blood pressure also, you should practice this mudra. Then what are the benefits? It actually strengthens the heart and regulates even the palpitation. Whenever there is an irregular heartbeat, we call it as palpitation. Either there is a bradycardia or tachycardia. So that also comes under control if you practice this. And it regulates your excretory system and problems of gastric trouble. So this is Apana Mudra or Mudra of Heart. Now the next one is called as Linga Mudra. Okay. Now Linga Mudra is just holding the finger. Keep any of the thumb. There is nothing, no right or left kind of a thing. You have to clench it, like interlock your fingers with both the hands and keep the thumb of the left hand vertically straight. Right hand also you can do, but left hand vertically straight and encircle it with the thumb on the index finger on the right hand, like this. See, it means my finger is going like this in this, others are interlocked. Again, I'm showing, I'm making O with my right hand, pushing this finger like this, interlocking them. So this is Linga Mudra. Okay. Actually, Linga Mudra is supposed to generate heat in the body. When you practice this mudra, it is written in the text that you will have to take a lot of milk and ghee and other water and fruit and the fruit juices. In addition to practice of this mudra, there are a lot of benefits. And because it generates heat, we'll have to take the cooling ahara, like, you know. You practice this at any time of the day you want. The best thing about mudras is, oh no, you have to take bath and set, you have to do it in the morning or at a particular time. No, anytime, anywhere you can do this, you can get the same benefits. So it actually stops the production of phlegm and gives power to lungs. So any respiratory condition is cured. It cures severe cold and bronchitic infection and bronchial infection, and also it helps the body to invigorate itself. So Linga Mudra is very powerful, especially if you are in a place where there is a lot of cold and if you don't have a lot of clothes to carry, this mudra can really help you. In the sense, please, it will keep you invigorated. I'm not going to say it will substitute a sweater or a coat. It's not like that, but it will keep you healthy. Then, this is very easy, Samana Mudra. Bring all the fingers, five fingers, gently together and join the tips of all the fingers and just keep it. It controls your digestive disorders and helps the digestive system. You can do it for 20 minutes minimum. Okay, it digests the food and nourishes the body, enhances the functions of digestive system, prevents and cures many problems associated with the digestive system, right from indigestion to gastric formation, belching, all these things are controlled with this. You could do, all of you could do this, I think. This is very simple, right? Okay. Now, this one is Hakini Mudra. You must have seen those who watch Jaggi Vasudev Ji, constantly he is in this finger, and there are one or two, Vijay's also used to come, so they also would do this, and anchors, TV anchors, I've seen them doing. This is a very powerful mudra, which is called as Hakini Mudra. Again, gently touching all the fingers together. Don't press. The minute you press hard, that is lost. So very gently you touch and try to feel the pulsation or, throbbing. So what, 15 minutes minimum, this helps concentration like anything. And it promotes the actually coordination between your right and left hemispheres of brain. That is why we have to teach it to children. And it helps the children suffering from autism. And, for children with autism, you have to tell this mudra along with Jnana Mudra. And this together, these two can really be helpful for them. And practically, it can, I don't say completely cured, but partially you can cure autism with this mudra. This I have seen, of course, their medicines and everything they have to follow. But with this Hakini Mudra and Jnana Mudra combined, 15 minutes of this, 15 minutes of this Hakini Mudra. So both of them, you make the children do 3-4 times in a day at periodic breakup intervals, and it definitely helps. And another thing I'll tell you, whenever we are doing mudras, I'm telling you, focus, and see whether there is a pulsation, whether there is this. By doing this, what actually you're doing is, you are making a sankalpa, you are taking a thing that, okay, I need to cure, and it's all about faith. If you say, what is this rubbish, I don't get anything, you won't get anything. So it's all energy and centers and everything. So you are focusing on that, automatically your mind is away from so many thoughts at that particular time. Try to understand the logic behind. So ultimately, all your problems originate in your mind, all the diseases originate in your mind, and then they come into manifestation. So by focusing on these mudras, like, you know, every day, even if you do 45 minutes, different mudras, even when you don't have any problem also, it will make you focus. Why we say meditation is so powerful? In meditation, what you are doing? You are actually withdrawing your senses. You are keeping yourself away from the thoughts. And that is where, like, we close the eyes and sit. Why? Because if I keep my eyes open and all that, so many things are there to distract. So why we have to close the eyes? It is not just to give a, like, you know, look of meditation. It's not that way. It's withdrawing the senses. So like how in Indian philosophy, how meditation is told is, it is like a tortoise, kachua. So how tortoise can withdraw all the head and the legs together and just lie down like a shell, like that our human body should withdraw from all the senses and remain in that condition, then the body starts healing. So your mind is very powerful, but we have to leave the mind to do its work, like, you know, do some beneficial work also. Constantly we are bogged down by the thoughts and this happened, that happened, because the mental traffic is so much, it's uncontrollable. So meditation is best done early in the morning when mental traffic is zero, maybe around 4, if you can't get up at 4, whenever you get up, 10-15 minutes also. Meditation is not about sitting and, chanting your God's name. If you don't want to chant any God's name, don't chant. Just close your eyes and observe your thoughts. Don't think of anything. Just observe your breath. Control your thoughts. That itself is meditation. If you believe in God, chant God's name. Otherwise, just observe your breath and sit. And that immensely helps. I have been practicing for the last at least 40-45 years. Right from childhood, I've been practicing meditation. Whatever time, sometimes I sleep at 1:30, 2 in the night, but still I get up at 4:30. I don't know. I have to get up because that's the conditioning of the mind. 4:30, I get up and I do my meditation, and then the whole day goes on like that. I generally sleep early, but there are some days when it just day stretches quite long, you know. So that is what for today. I hope you got something. If you have any doubts, you could ask. I'll be happy to explain. What happened? Do you want me to, you have any queries?
I would like to say that it is a wonderful session, because we generally don't concentrate on these things. These are such simple things which are really, really good for everyone, whether it's a child or an elder person. It's really good. I would love to have the PPT if you can share, or maybe we can have another section, because I really enjoyed this session. It's really, really, we don't get into it because our mind is always occupied with so many things that we don't think that these things are important, and we don't take out time also to do all these things. It's a pleasure listening to you, ma'am. I must say it was a wonderful session, and please let me know the name of the book. I would love to read that. And
I will put it in the chat box right away. Who is this talking? I couldn't see you. I could only hear you.
I'm Anurag, so I'm not putting my video on, but I'll definitely do so for 1 second. This is Anurag.
Arundhati, ma'am, you can just stop the screen sharing so that we all can see each other and discuss any queries if anybody is having.
Okay.
Yeah, now it's perfectly fine. So, Arundhati.
Actually, she put it very well, you know, because we are so much involved in day-to-day activities. How many times actually, like, you know, we do everything so mechanically, there is no time for reflection at all. Even if we start reflecting our day, whole day, what I did, what I could have done better, and what went wrong, and did I, you know, like, I do that reflection for years, like, before going to bed, it's become part of my daily routine. I just, you know, entire day runs, And somewhere, sometimes inadvertently, we hurt somebody, inadvertently, we talk something. Even those things can, if they come across my mind, I immediately tell, oh, I shouldn't have done this. I should have done it in a better way. So I don't even have any I don't stay on the any formality. I go and tell next day to that person, I'm sorry, yesterday, what I meant to say is this. Sometimes we want to say something, but it goes in a different way. I have no reservations at all. So that's very important. And, you know, this is, it's in your hand only. Health is in your hands, but we just neglect. As I said, everything is fast ka zamana. If I do a Jnana Mudra, I expect that I have to get 90% immediately. It's not going to happen. So we have to do it.
Ma'am,
many of the people may be busy because, you know, all of us are having so many other
problems. Ma'am, with the mudras, you spoke about the frozen shoulders and all that. And most of the time with this frozen, like with this mudras, if we can just cure that and thyroid and so many things you mentioned, let's say unconsciously we are not knowing but following these mudras. It was really awesome, like each and every aspect. Last time we heard, we learned about signature, how can we change our life. Today we are learning by just following simple mudras. We can just heal our body and sort out many health issues. So it was really awesome. Madhumita ma'am, Anurashi ma'am, Krishin, any of you have any queries regarding that, you can just put it to Arundhati ma'am. She would be happy to help.
Yeah, can I ask a question? I just have a question.
Yes, please.
Thank you, ma'am. It was really a very, very informative and awesome session.
Thank you so much.
It was really wonderful. And my question is that you said about 10 to 15 minutes each day you practice, and this has to be on practice every day, on every day basis, right? So Now I want to know, when you are practicing this, be it only for 10 minutes or be it only for 15 minutes, Do you actually, when you're practicing the mudras, do you concentrate on your breath as well? Or do you
There is no need for breath over here, because breathing actually we do it, normal only. We don't have to go in for, I'm just trying to share the link with you, a Google link. So I was taking time. Sorry. 1 minute, just.
Ma'am, you can also, if you are not able to do it here.
No, I'm able to do it.
We can also put it in the group so that.
See, I put it there. I already pasted it. Okay, sorry. Now your question. See, like any time of the day you can practice. There is no need to observe the breath. Trust me, when you focus on the throbbing, automatically your breathing gets corrected. If I tell you, okay, breathe from your tummy and breathe, take so many times, then your focus will go there. You will not focus on what you're doing. Okay. Our body is beautifully designed, actually. If you just hold it, and I kept on telling, observe, hold it very gently, observe peripheral touch. So if you just touch like this, okay, then, you know, automatically your breathing, when your mind calms down, when you focus on a particular thing, your breathing automatically goes into a right pattern. Uh-huh. And another thing I will tell you, like, you know, as we grow older, we forget about breathing. Now you see a baby when it is born, and you know, up to 3 months or 4 months, and observe your own baby, how he or she breathes. Actually the tummy will be going up and down, up and down, up and down. See the cats and dogs especially, up and down, up and down. So God has designed this machine to breathe completely this thing. But we are always in a hurry. Constantly we are in a hurry. Before somebody else says, I have to answer this, I have to do that. So most of the time our problems are due to shallow breathing. So make deep breathing your pattern. Whatever you are doing, whether you are talking also. See, nothing is, you are not going to miss anything in life if you take deep breaths and talk. It's okay. And how the singers and all, why singers live for long? Because constantly they are breathing through their navel. So because the raga and alapa has to come like that through the navel, right? So that's how the longevity is there. So why I'm telling all this is deep breathing also is very important. And the minute you start focusing your mind, even when you're sitting in the meditation, just observe your breath. Apne aap, like, it will start becoming very rhythmic and that follow pattern. Because your mind is not hassled. The traffic is zero. So that's what I would say. So no need to take special care about breathing. You can just focus on that.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, Arundhati ma'am. It was awesome, like through our breathing, how we can heal so much. See, a lot of things, as Anurashi ma'am rightly said, that we don't pay attention to basic pointers. With this, I would formally ask Anita ma'am to give a vote of thanks for such a lovely session.
Thank
you. It was a Wiki Wisdom session too. So Anita ma'am, over to you.
Thank you. Actually, this is such a vast subject. You had given me 1 hour. See, I finished 5 minutes before, because I don't want to overshoot and go on and this thing. So I said, I did this for even senior citizens. I did it, do this for corporates. Little in a detail, it depends on the duration and what we, things are. And also chakra healing I take, and I take on the meditation also. I don't teach meditation in the real sense. Nahi, Ram ka mat japo, only Krishna ka japo, nothing, like no gods, nothing, but, you know, proper meditation. And then there are also, breathing practices, pranayama also I take sessions. So,
ma'am, share the link of this mudras if there is the classes, because I have a senior citizens club. I have just started something for senior citizens only. So I would like to learn it myself so that I can teach them. It's an online club.
Now, actually, within another hour, it will be uploaded on the YouTube. I'm very fast. I don't want to procrastinate.
Thank you, ma'am.
That was great, ma'am. And definitely 1 hour for any subject. See, we are having it 1 hour is too less, but definitely yes, we will come back again with a new learning with you. And thank
you. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Good evening, all. It gives me an immense pleasure to deliver the vote of thanks for this session to all the dignitaries who are assembled here. I would like to thank our speaker, Dr. who, besides being an eminent educationist, is an expert in mudra therapy for common ailments. I am confident that the simple techniques would go a long way in helping all the participants and maintain their mind, body, and soul in a well-balanced manner. Today's session was full of wisdom and interesting takeaways. A humble gratitude to Dr. Arundhati ma'am for having taken time off her busy schedule and to enlighten us on this mudra therapy. I would also like to thank Seema ma'am and Rachna ma'am for organizing such a wonderful session, and all the educators for participating and making the session a grand success. Once again, thank you. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Anita. Actually, why I love this Wiki group is, like, here people are open-minded and they're eager to learn. And this girl, though, I don't have to say, Rachna, oh my God, she's so dynamic. God bless her. Keep your energies, learn new things, share new things. And thank you, Christine, for the introduction. And thank you, Anita, for whatever good things you told. And somewhere again, we will connect and we'll empower each other, I would say. Like, you know, what I know, I will share. And I'm eager to learn anything from you guys also. So thank you very much.
My privilege, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Small request. We would like to have the PPTs, what you have actually presented today. It is really amazing, so that we can see and we can even understand what exactly each mudra, you know, benefits and, you know, and our ailment of.
I'll be sharing the video only. Everything is there, Anita.
Okay, fine.
Because if you see the PPT, you will be just reading. All the commentary will not be there. Video will be, I have my channel, so I'll be putting it immediately.
Sure.
Okay, within next 1 hour, and I'll paste the link in the group.
Sure.
You're too fast in that, I must say.
I am.
Very good, ma'am.
Tomorrow I'm doing a talk for mompreneurs. OBSI.
There are rapid talks, May month say. I must have done around 90 talk shows, and hardly 10 I have uploaded on my YouTube. I used to go live on Facebook, and then YouTube thing, because I never get time to do it. Too fast in it. I love that.
thank you so much, thank you, Arundhati ma'am. It was thank a wonderful you. Listening to you, it's a great learning.
Actually, it was thank a you. Great learning. And yes, we will have another session with Arundhati ma'am. And as you all have read in the message, one child, she passed away in Seema ma'am's school, so she couldn't join in. This happened just last moment. 4:30 Seema ma'am just messaged me that she will be joining from car. She said, I will be just leaving from school in 10 minutes and join when while she'll be in the car. And then immediately message aaya ki yes.
And it's very unfortunate. So I text her back, may the child's soul be blessed. And, you know, we don't say rest in peace because we don't believe in resting. It is a continuation always. So onward journey, it takes up onward journey. So Sadgati is what we say, you know. Sadgati is what we say. The best.
She never used to talk, you know.
She's a very, very learning.
Then we used to take her sessions in that, you know. She never used to talk, just a smiling, smiling face. When ma'am sent me a photo, she said, you know her, Rachna. And when I saw her, so everything, kids... Every day, whatever you say, she'll just keep on smiling.
So this
we end today's session. Have a good day. And we will come up with another new session.